Good evening, everyone. Chodesh Tov, happy new moon of Leo. Now, the reason why we do this, have a little class, is because we want to connect or tap into the seed level of the energy of the new moon. And we know this is what the knowledge of Kabbalah is about. It gives us insight into what's going on in the universe so we can achieve more control in our life, simply. We don't want to be subject to the influences of the zodiac or the environment within the realm of nature. The Kabbalists explain that you and I have the ability to rise above nature to whatever degree that we know and connect. Of course, that's two parts. First, we have to know. We have to desire, of course. And then we need to make the effort and use the tools to connect. So let's start by giving a little bit of insight what this month is about, what the constellation is about. And we know there's no better source for the Kabbalists than going to the seed level, the oldest known written document that speaks about astrology, which is called the Book of Formation. Now, the Book of Formation is attributed to Abraham the patriarch, the biblical Abraham. Most people don't know he was a master astrologer, and he spoke about all the planets and all the constellations to assist us in the later generations how to be able to elevate above the natural influence of the zodiac, the constellations, and so on. And again, there are those who will say there are older wisdoms that deal with astrology, perhaps Chinese astrology, which may be as old as 10,000 years, but nothing written. The oldest known written document is approximately 4,000 years old, dating back to the time of Abraham. So let me read now from the Book of Formation. I'm going to read in the ancient language of Aramaic Hebrew, and I will translate. So specifically pertaining to this month, and we read this because we want to connect, because we know knowing is the greatest form of connection. And it says, Himlich ot kaf v'kasha lo ketev v'tza bo chama ba'olam v'yom dalet ba'shana v'ozen smol ba'nefesh. The letters, which again referring to the Aramaic letters, which the Kabbalists explain are like DNA. They are merely forms or symbols that represent cosmic forces or vibrations, if you will. And that shouldn't be a problem for us because we know DNA is very small. It shouldn't be an issue for us to understand energetic vibrations and that how they can create constellations, planets, or whatever. So in this case, we are discussing the planet and the constellations. So the Book of Formation says that the letter Kaf, which I'll show you in a moment, it's called Kaf, presented itself, and it was bound with a crown, and from it was formed the sun, the fourth day of the week, which that would be Wednesday, the fourth day of the week, Wednesday, and the left ear in the human being. Okay, so here it's telling us that this force, which is called Kaf, and I'll show that to you right now. So here is the symbol or the letter, which is called Kaf. The energy or the cosmic force behind it, this is what creates or is the energetic vibration behind the sun. And the fourth day of the week, which we call Wednesday, and the left ear in the human being. Okay? Now we have another symbol which is called Tet, and this is for the constellation of Leo. Let me read you directly from the source. Again, so the Book of Formation is explaining. Himlich ot tet the letter Tet, that letter which I just showed you, the form or symbol, presented itself, and it was bound with a crown, and from it was formed the constellation of Leo, the lion, and the lion and the constellation which we call Leo, or Av. And it's interesting, in the Aramaic or the ancient Hebrew, the constellation of Leo is called Av, Av, A-V, Av. Now, in modern Hebrew, Av also means father. Interesting, father. So Leo has something to do with father, the energy of father. Also, the right kidney. Okay, so the energy itself also creates the right kidney. Okay, so we have information. Of course, information is no good to us unless we understand what to do with it. Now, I just want to remind us that our purpose in this, having this discussion at all, is because we know cosmic forces are always occurring. They are constantly at work, and we are influenced. Now, one of the things that Abraham the patriarch explained is the stars, the constellations, impel, but they do not compel, which means they will influence us, and if we don't know anything about it, and we don't know how to use specific tools to counteract whatever the natural negative effects may be, because there's always both positive and negative. Now, our job is to learn how to tap into the positive forces and protect ourselves from whatever negative influences they may be hanging out there, okay? Because there's always a balance of positive and negative in the cosmic, always. So our job is going to be always to separate the two, tap into the positive, and learn how to protect ourselves or work against the negative or achieve control over the negative. Now, of course, one may ask, well, why do I need to do that? I mean, why is there negative? That's, of course, for a basic discussion of Kabbalah. But suffice to say, we are not here. It is not possible for us to receive beneficence in life, true beneficence in life, above our nature by doing nothing. There is a rule in the universe that everything must be earned. Everything which is going to be real and lasting for us, that means it's not going to come and go, meaning it's real fulfillment, some level of fulfillment, wherever it comes from, in our sustenance, in our livelihood, career, relationships, love life, health, means it's not a quick change and temporary. No, it's a long-lasting change and gets better. So that's what we call true. True. So there's the illusion of change and the illusion of blessing, and then there's the real stuff. How do we know it's real? It stays and it increases. When it's not real, it's false fulfillment, it starts high. Could be an instant gratification or a high level, high powered good or high, and then it gradually wanes. Unfortunately, most things in life start up and they gradually get worse or less. I don't want to say worse, as time goes on. But true things in life, and we do have some of those too, thank goodness, that they may not start high, but they build over time and they get better and better and better over time. Sort of like a good bottle of wine. So, getting back to the discussion, our purpose and the reason why we want to celebrate or at least acknowledge and understand the cosmic forces that are available is so that we can connect and tap in to the positive forces, and this way we can eliminate some of the chaos in our life that may be part and parcel of that system. Everything, again, has both all the time. Again, our job is to tap into the good, the positive, and take charge, take control over the negativities or whatever chaos may be also available. Okay, so getting back to Leo, let's understand the constellation itself simply by understanding the zodiac sign of Leo. Now, this is one of the constellations that also, from the zodiac point of view, it depends if it's a male or female. And let me ask for forgiveness ahead of time. I don't mean to poke fun at anyone. And so if you happen to be a Leo, please don't take this personally, because every one of the 12 constellations has both sides as well, as everything does, a positive and a negative. So again, our job is to also understand the negative so that we can understand how to work with it. Because if it's there and we don't understand it, we're not conscious of it, chances are we'll be a little bit robotic, we won't know, and we can be making mistakes or falling into those traps, not know about it. So better to know about it and be working or understand how to overcome those flaws. So suffice to say that probably we all know that Leos are, they like to be leaders, they're good initiators of things, and they're very charming types of people, and they can be very magnanimous, they can be very sharing people. And again, now depending on male or female, there will be an element of control or not, because the female Leos will tend to have all those other characteristics, but also be more controlling. Now, there's, and I'll explain to you why, because first of all, we understand that many of the constellations are represented by animals. And of course, Leo is the lion. Now, what is the lion? King of the jungle. Now, there is a lion, but there's a lioness. Now, I don't know how many of us understand the difference between the lion and the lioness, but there's a big difference, because the lion is the king. So if you ask, well, what's the job of the king, the lion, the king of the jungle? And that's the answer. He is the king, and that's his job. He be the king. Now, what does the king do? A good king, he sits on his throne. And, you know, if he's the lion, maybe he swats some flies with his tail. But he's there for the show. And he really, the truth of the matter is, the lion doesn't do that much. He sits and puts on the show. Now, of course, the lioness is very different in that respect. She takes care of the young. She goes out for the kill. She brings back the food. Almost like she's doing it all, while the king is, again, doing his job, being a good king and kind of hanging out. So this also is reflected to some male forces of Leo, which tend to display some laziness or some issue of that sort to overcome or to deal with as a character trait. Laziness at some level. Even if it's not physical laziness, it may be emotional or spiritual laziness. It may be an intellectual laziness, or it may be a physical laziness, okay? Now, the female will be controlling and very protective of her young, and therefore the female lionesses or the female Leos will tend to be very, could be overprotective mothers. Again, please don't send me comments and tell me how wrong I am. It could be. Doesn't mean it's you. Please don't take it personally. So these are just some characteristics. Of course, there are many, and they're both positive and negative, just like every other constellation. But the most important thing for us to understand about the constellation of Leo is Leo is one of the 3 months, just like the month that we're going out of tonight, the month of Cancer. It's one of the 3 months, which are Cancer, Leo, and Capricorn, which don't have a balanced force of protection. In other words, they have great potential of energy to be revealed, but they don't have a naturally balanced force or a cushion. So we'll call it that way. The code name is Shekhinah. There's no innate force of balance. Now, that means in those 3 months, we have responsibility to inject the mercy, the cushion, and the balance in the month ourselves. Okay? We can't depend on the universe to take care of it, as we may be able to a little bit more so any other 9 months. But this month is considered by some a difficult month or very challenging month because lots of negative things could happen in this month, and it could be a negative period, a very down period. Now, we know there's no such thing as down without being a commensurate up. That's the way the universe works. And the Kabbalists explained that the most difficult day of Leo is the ninth day of Leo. Now, that ninth day of Leo, the Kabbalists explain, has two portions. It is half of the ultimate negative, destruction, chaotic, and it's the ultimate good, prosperity, good, creative, sustenance, everything that is represented, good, creation energy, the opposite of destruction energy. So it's two parts. And in fact, half the day begins with the negative, and then after midday, there's a force of positive. And it's interesting that some of the Kabbalists explain that it's even a good day to fast, not eat food, to restrict physical pleasures, because by doing that is a way of eliminating negativity. So there are some people who do that. So we're not going to go into that whole discussion, but suffice to say that this month is an extremely interesting month for the understanding of how to take control, because it is a month of control. That's one of the key words. Control. Creation through control. Now, what is the control that we're discussing here? Now, we know Leo is ruled by the sun, and it's only one of 2 months, the month that we just passed, which is Cancer, and this month, Leo, which are both ruled by one planet. Cancer ruled by the moon, Leo ruled by the sun. Now, of course, all the other constellations, the other five constellations, share their energy. The planets control two. In other words, Gemini and Virgo are ruled by Mercury. So Mercury takes both. Venus controls Taurus. It divides its energy to two constellations, Taurus and Libra, and so on. Saturn, Capricorn, and Aquarius. So every other of the five planets have two constellations attached, but it's only Leo and Cancer that have one planet. And therefore, in Leo, the sun is completely focused. It's very intense. The sun is very focused in what? In all of its energy is focused into this constellation, into one constellation. Now, we know the sun is the power of life. Again, there's a duality and there's a balance. Nothing can exist without the sun. Gives life. On the other hand, you get too close, you burn, you get a sunburn. That's no fun. Or you burn up. So the sun has that power of life and death in the same place. It's creation and destruction. Again, that's what it's all about. So we know the tendency of Leo, and just the way the sun is, everything revolves around the sun. And this is the concept of ego. So we understand that ego means when everything revolves around me, and those are my thoughts. I think it's all about me. Now, we all have that. It's not those people that we know. We all have it in our own way, in our own flavor. Every constellation has, you know, it's all about me in some respect. You know, Gemini would be, it's all about my intelligence. And Libra might be, it's all about my beauty. And Taurus, it's all about my comfort. And Virgo is all about how smart and I know everything and I'm perfect. And so each one of us has, it's all about me in some respect. And that's part of our karma to correct, to create more positive energy. That's what we were given to do. It's part of our job. Leo is the seed of the energy for all of us. And again, it's not the Leos themselves, mind you. It's the energy which we all participate in, that it's all about me and everything revolves around me. That's the force. Now, and that's why in the cosmic symbol, which represents Leo, look how interesting it is, because this represents a vibration of energy. The symbol goes inside itself. Isn't that interesting? It goes inside itself to signal to us, this is the nature of the month. Meaning, if you're a Leo, and if you're not a Leo, you will be affected by the energy of the month as we always are. We need to be conscious, because probably we haven't been aware of it. That this month we have a tendency to be more inside ourselves, but not in the right way. Now, what do I mean? This month, we don't want to be inside ourselves, meaning everything surrounds us and it's all about us. But rather, this is the month not for looking outside at other people, how they are all about themselves. No, no. This is the ideal month. If we want to create positive energy, this is the month for us to look inside in an introspective way and to look at how I'm inside myself and how I can go outside myself for the sake of other people. It's one of the most powerful tools we can use this month. How to go outside myself to share with other people for their sake. Now, when I say for their sake, I mean not for my sake, because the classic Leo may do lots of sharing with others. You know, he can buy his whole office dinner or lunch and say, put it on my tab, Joe. But why? Because he cares about the staff? He may. But it won't hurt if other people see me doing that, if you know what I mean. And other people will know what a good guy I am, because there's nothing for a Leo than being, especially a Leo man, is what a great guy I am. And I'm very worried about what others think of me. Because again, the show, remember our friend, the King of the Jungle? It's about the show. So again, this is not just for the new moon of Leo. This is how to fix our consciousness all the way, always, all year, how that stuff relates to us, because this relates to all of us. And again, the sun is the operative, because the sun is again the force of energy which everything revolves around. Now we want the energy, but in order for that energy to affect us in a positive way, I have to consider others. I need to respect others. If I need to go out of my way, better. The more effort that I need to do to go out of my way to show respect to others, to give others, to surround others with it, not me. In other words, to take myself out of being surrounded and to give you the opportunity. And those types of actions of sharing truly for the sake of others and not for our own personal agendas. But the more we go out of our own agenda in this respect this month, the more benefit, the more energy we will achieve. Remember, this symbol, and it will help to even contemplate, meditate, if you can see these two symbols above your head with a white light, that would be great, and being filled, because this is a vibration, nothing more. But it's the perfect vibration for this month. Again, we by connecting with this, we actually go outside of ourselves. We resist. This helps us to resist being involved only being inside of ourselves. And this is to help us tap in to the positive energy of the sun, the life-giving, the creative, the growth part of the sun, and to help reduce. It's like a filter. Just like we use sunscreen of some sort, we don't stay out in the sun all day without some kind of protection. This assists us with the cosmic protection from the harmful rays that we don't benefit from that can cause us harm. So these are the tools for this month. And again, this is the month that we need to be really careful about being reactive to our personal agendas when it relates to our own egos with respect to respect, surrounding ourselves, being in the center of attention, again, the negative aspects. But when we go and we push against it, what we call the resistance, and we go outside, we look outside of ourselves, we look how we can help others, give a good word, again, not looking for the reward, not looking for feedback, not caring what others are thinking about us in any sense, because many times that stops us from doing what we really need to do, but we're sometimes a little too concerned how we look, how people view us, and all that whole other discussion. And everything else we talked about will assist all of us in having a month full of energy, positive creation, not destruction, protection from any form of destruction, and being the most creative and taking that energy with us, because this month is the vehicle for that creative energy and being the doer. All when we understand also important that the real control that we want to achieve is control over ourselves and not control over others. That's true control. When we learn to control ourselves, the environment will automatically be controlled. We will achieve more cosmic control, more synchronicity, more things that happen the way we need them to happen rather than the way we think they should happen. And that can usually backfire, okay? We want the cosmic to guide us in its own perfect way rather than for us to make the decisions with our limited brain. And sometimes we have no choice, of course, we do the best we can, but whenever it's possible, and the new moon is always that great opportunity for that, is to call on the energy of the universe, tap into the cosmic forces so that we take more control over the internal force of energy and thereby taking the seed level of control. Now, when you control the seed, everything else has to follow. And we don't always have to know what we're doing. We just need to be guided in the right direction. And that's what we want. Blessings to all of us on this new moon of Leo. And for all of us, have a wonderful and blessed month full of all the good energy for all of us.